Hi, my name's Keith Lemon, and it's time to get the team together. Bang Tidy. That's Ollie Willoughby be doing daytime TV. Bang Tidy. There's Fern Cotton doing radio.
It says here, Bang Tidy.
There's me mate Rufus Sound doing stammer. Every year we join as a unit to make the best telly show on telly. What is that telly show? It's Celebrity Jukes. On telly.
Get me out here, Celebrity Juice special. Without further ado, let's meet our team captains. First up, she's got bangers, it's Holly Willoughby! Who's on your team, Holly?
Well, to my right, I have I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here Now, very, very funny man, it's Russell Kane! And Italian stallion. It's Gino the Cat!
Let's meet our other team captain. She's equally bang tidy, it's Fern Cotton! Who's on your team?
I've got our very own Tarzan, Rufus Hound!
Rider, do you want to get inside her?
Sean, welcome to Celebrity Jukes.
Thank you.
I'm a big fan of Happy Mondays. I'm a big fan of Black Grape. I'm a big fan of Sean Ryder. When you're going, it's coming up, it's coming up, it's coming up. And that was with the Gorillaz. I was a big fan of you in the jungle. You just lost out to Stacey Solomon. But she's a lovely person, isn't she?
Yeah. Yes.
What was your worst memory of being in the jungle? Got with a snake, yeah?
Yeah.
How long was it holding you for, can you remember?
About 20 minutes.
Was it?
Yeah.
So how did they get it off? Show them a picture of Fern Cotton.
And it went black.
I quite like the idea, though, of the snake drinking Sean Ryder's blood after 20 minutes.
Sean, you've got a book out.
I have, yeah.
It's called Twisting Me Melon. What does that mean?
It means doing me nothing.
In conjunction with your phrase, Twisting Your Melon Man, I'm going to give you all a chance to win bonus points before we actually start the quiz. I'm going to give you some vegetables. If you can twist them and snap them, then you win a point for your team.
Okay.
So, first up, you're up, Sean, first. So, this is your vegetable. It's a courgette. That's, if you're posh,
yeah,
that's,
yeah.
It's a cucumber, it's the posh cucumber.
Zucchini.
So if you can twist it and break it, oh, it's a point for your team.
Yes.
Holly.
Nobody can do that.
It's a butternut squash. If you can't twist it and snap it, I'll give you a point if you just kiss it there.
Oh my God, listen to yourself! So desperate for points! You kissed his fake bollocks on TV! Butternut squash, thank you.
This is great wanking material.
Russell Kane, you're not the same. You look different to me. You've changed your image, haven't you?
Yeah, I know. I was having a breakdown, so I ended up looking like the aborted triplet of Jedward.
Let's see just how much you do look like Jedward. Can we get a close-up on him? What?
Okay,
And let's put Jedwin. Look!
It's a mangled version, look.
You look like a posse of trolls.
Gino, did you say the Italian word for fanny on this morning?
What is it?
I just remember this. No, it was something you cooked, and then suddenly yes, it was figs. That was it. That was it. And you were trying to teach us the Italian word for fig, and you told us what it was. So Bill and I are going, what did you say?
Fika.
Fika, fika, fika. Oh, fika, 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 like this. And after somebody tweeted me and went, you do realise Gino just got you to say the Italian word for fanny?
Yeah, because in Italy, fika means figs and floppy thing. What did you say?
With Celebrity Juice. The first round is called Bush Looker Trial. We showed 100 members of our studio audience pairs of celebrities connected to I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, and asked them to say whether they thought they were better looking or a bush looker. You have to guess what the public have said. First up, Holly, your pair is Katie Price, showering in the jungle, and Mylene Klass, also showering in the jungle. Oh, who said they were a bush looker or who was like bang tidy and they wanted to do a dirty with them?
I think that most people would go for the au naturel look here. I mean, boys.
Yeah. Yeah. Stino, you're a man, help her. Russell, you're a lesbian, help her.
I would personally go for a naturel because I don't like, because they like plastic boobies, I don't like it. I'd rather small one, but not plastic.
Why, because they're too solid?
Yeah, plus you can't really flick or do anything. You know what I mean?
Gino! What about Fern?
There is potential there.
You like Fern, though, don't you?
If you give them to me, I'll grow them. Because there is a technique. Yes, there is a technique.
To make them bigger.
Yeah.
Jingle, shower.
Yeah. No, don't
you know what you do? You can up one size.
How? Sorry, you might be about to make yourself a million, billion, zillion pounds if you know how to do that.
Yes, because it's the way you massage, you suck them. There is a massage to do around, you suck them. Seriously, my wife, she's got massive money.
I thought you were going to do that thing of I can make your boobs grow bigger with massage, or I give you £200. See, there's a win-win situation, right?
Yeah.
So then he's there for 20 minutes, and he goes, they're not bigger, there's your £200.
So Holly's team, who did the audience say was better looking?
Hey, I would say Mylene.
Mylene, let's see what they said. Correct! Fern, your pair is Sheffield's finest, Gino Di Campo, and he loves his kids, mate. I love my kids, mate. Peter Andre, he loves his kid, mate. He loves his kids.
Right.
I've been in rooms with Peter Andre, and those rooms have had the brisk air of a spring afternoon. I've never been in a room with Gino Di Campo where it wasn't the middle of summer.
Oh, beautiful.
People love Gino Di Campo in a way that is physically threatening.
Yeah. Sean, who do you think is fitter? Who's making you tingle out of those two?
I'm pretty tingling.
Gino.
Yeah, well, I go. They're shouting Gino, so let's go. Gino! And the scores at the end of that round are. Shifting! The VT round. VT stands for videotape. Let's look at the videotape to tell us what the VT round is all about.
It's Key versus Jedwin! Around the world! The French for Onion Eating Challenge!
So in this round, myself and Jeff Wood flew to Gay Paris to eat a raw onion. Who consumed the onion the fastest? This is what a raw onion looks like.
That's what a raw onion looks like. The thing about eating a raw onion is that your taste buds then send messages up to your brain that tell you something isn't right.
Really?
And on those grounds, Jedward will win this in a heartbeat.
That's a very good point. Strong point.
So you'll say Jedward.
We'll go Jedward.
Right. They say Jedward. Who are you saying, Holly?
Right, we're going you.
It's just a me.
Yeah.
You said Jedward.
Yeah.
You said me. Let's have a look.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Jean. Je Edward. The kid we are, Jedward. Qui de l'émot is up.
Bon jovi, I'm Keith Lemon, welcome to Paris. Today's challenge is a simple affair. The onion, which was invented by the Frenchman, is underneath here. All we have to do is consume the onion. Whoever consumes the most or the quickest onion. Will win the point.
This is crazy. My eyes are going to crack.
Go, John, go, John, go, John, John, hurry up, okay? No time for losers, okay? You gotta win. Go, John, go, John, go, 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 go. Come on, John, come on, come on, come on, come on. Hurry up. Hurry up, eat it. Come on, John, go, go, go. You are a born warrior. You want to eat onions. Come on, friend, come on. Eat it now. Stop wasting time. No time for losers. You got your breath in your hair. You got garlics around you.
He's beating me.
Hurry up, John. I'm
no.
To distract him.
Okay, I'm trying. It's all burning me at her. Don't worry. Okay.
Don't
burn
you.
No, wait, okay.
Winners get burnt.
I can't continue.
He's so sick. It's like crazy. Do people in France actually do this? Come on, your eyes are so red. Why are they red? John, be strong, be strong. Hurry up, John, come on.
Boosh!
Have a little wee. We'll see you in three. Coming
on, Master Black. Johnny. Kayleigh. Got a boyfriend. My dressing room, it says Keith Lemon on it.
So, welcome back to Celebrity Juice. Gino, you've got a book out. Italian Home Baking
is all the stuff Italian that you can bake at home, like pizza.
Yes.
Or biscuit, like the cantuccini.
What do you say?
Cantuccini.
Cantuccini?
Cantuccini.
Gino, when you talk, I'm just, my heart is rejoiced. I just fill with joy, because all I can hear is, Ipitatupitepitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitipitip
Because we know you really talk like that, don't you? You talk like Sam from Sam and Mark. That's how you talk in real life, isn't it, Gino? Hey?
No, I don't talk like that. I talk just.
I'm going to show you how to make a pork pie.
Remember the moment you got a letter from a loved one when you were in jungle?
Yes, I can. Yes, we got the I got the letter, and I think Justin read the letter for me because I couldn't read it
because you were too emotional.
Yes,
or because
yes,
you're
yes.
backwards.
Because I was too emotional, so yeah. I couldn't read it. So I said, "Can you read it
but
for me?"
Did he do it like your voice? You know, like in films where they read letters, but voice comes from somewhere else.
Dad, I don't half miss you, I do.
No, it was his own voice.
He yeah, just... but when it was on telly, did it look like it was your voice reading it? You know, like doing films, when they read things.
I ran into you to tell you that I don't like you anymore. You are not my friend.
tell you what, I've got two letters here for you, Fern and Holly.
Oh, no.
Which I'm going to send you when you eventually are in the jungle eating kangaroos' hidden bits. And, Holly, here's your letter. You read it out. Let's see if I can make you cry. I know you can cry on cue, so don't fake it.
Dear Holly. Really miss your bangers knocking around. I've had to make do cracking one out whenever you have a shower. The bush looks lovely. Nice and shaved.
For God's sake.
Love, Key. P.S. Get down, bouncer, you flaming bastard.
That's Australian. That's their lingo.
Get down, bouncer, you flaming bastard.
Can you do Australian, Holly?
Get down, bouncer, you flaming bastard.
Fern, here's your letter.
Can't wait.
It's all from the art. I mean every word.
Thank you. Oh, God, it's a long one. The letter. Al Dufern was worried when your parachute didn't open. Thank God you floated down to Earth when your massive nostrils flared. I felt really sorry when I saw you in that coffin with all those rodents. Those poor rats. And those mosquito bites look painful. You should wear a bra. I hadn't really noticed you'd gone, so don't rush back. Keith, P.S. You have massive nostrils. So
we do jest, but it's all in jest, isn't it? We don't really hate each other, do we?
You are a wanker.
Up next is the cover story round. As you can see, opposite adjacent to me is a massive newer magazine with different categories on it. Our teams will choose a category, then I will ask them a question regarding that category. First up, it is Holly's team to choose a category.
Gina, would you like to choose one, please?
I'm going to go for I'm a celebrity, what the fuck? I'm screaming about.
I'm a celebrity. What the fuck am I screaming about? Yes!
I'm a celebrity. What the hell?
Kim, you're not knocking your onion on anything, are you? No. Your big ball thing.
I'm all
here. There it is! There it is! Now, you were in the jungle.
I was.
Were you in with Gino?
I was.
What was it like living with Gino?
Well, he's a bit rampant, dear.
Did you have a thing for him?
He talks about his genitals all day, dear.
Does he? Well, Kim Woodburn, everyone. Now, in this round, our panellists will move over to our jungle booth and will have to identify the screams of famous people that have been in I'm a Celebrity from the past. First up, it's Gino De Campo, so come on to the So here we are in the jungle booth. I'm going to put these bamboo shoot blinkers on you. So you can't see who is screaming on the screens.
I love
it.
Yeah. You can hear, yeah?
Yes, I can hear.
Yeah, but you can't see in your peripherals. You can't see you, can you?
No?
Okay. So you'll hear a scream, you'll have to identify the scream.
All right.
Okay, here's the first one.
Another celebrity.
Oh my God, it's rats!
The celebrity was, I can't remember his name, but was he not the one that he was doing somebody in the royal thing?
He did somebody in the royal thing.
Oh, I don't know. He
worked for the royal family.
Yes, yes. That's the one.
He's never going to get it.
Barrett.
What's
the name of the guy?
Paul Burrell.
Paul Burrell!
next clip. Who's that one?
Okay, that's the guy who does EastEnder.
Yes.
With the dog Willard. Willard.
Willow.
The dog's called Wellard.
Yeah, but it's not. It wasn't a dog. It wasn't a
well,
dog.
Hard.
It wasn't a dog.
Dean Haffney.
Dean Haffney. You need to be like Dean Gaffney. Everyone, Gino De Campo. You know what it's about.
Yeah.
Let's see if you can remember some of the people that have been in there.
Wow.
Yeah, looks good, that.
Yeah.
Can you just say Twisting the Melon Man?
You're Twisting my Melon Man.
OK, here's your first clip.
OK.
Does it taste salty?
Who could that be?
Got me.
You think it's you?
Exactly.
Why don't you just guess and say someone's name who was in there with you?
With me?
Yeah, baby.
Gillian.
If it was Kim Woodburn.
Who's that? I know who Kim is.
There she is.
Yeah, I know.
Sean Ryan, everyone! Next up is Russell King!
No!
Okay, here's the clip. What was that?
Honestly, I haven't got a clue. I'm going to just say Gino.
Oh, it was Christopher Biggins. Okay, here's your next one.
Oh! There it goes.
Oh my god! Oh, now they're going to my pants! You promised it would go to my pants!
Oh,
you know, you son of a...
Well, that's got to be Janice Dickinson, right?
Yes, Janice Dickinson! Well done, Russell Cain, everyone! And the scores at the end of that round are shitty! It's called Name It on the Jungle Boogie. So let's move over to my Jungle Boogie disco area. Yo, check it out, welcome to my disco, yeah, respect, recognise, wagwan. And you move it around, make it more exciting, come on, move it around, move it around. You tell it, the kids like it in and out. In and out. Right, top up, box. So, here. Look. Just like this, sort of like that, yeah?
Aww.
Yeah, put that on, man. I can hear all telly going on whilst you're on telly. You're all on telly, yeah! Hello. What's your name? Keely. Got a boyfriend? No. My dressing room, it says Keith Lemon on it. I have to show you. I'll show you my hidden bits. Like that, yeah? You seen MTV?
Yeah.
That MTV, yeah? OK, I'm going to drop you some beats. A member from your panel will have sound-cancelling earphones on. They will have to guess what the beat is just by your dance moves. First up, it's Russell with the sound-cancelling headphones on. So that's Holly's team that will be dancing for Russell. Drop the beat! Ooh! Next up to wear the sound cancelling headphones is none other than Sean Ryder. Yeah. I'm gonna drop the beat now, Sean.
Smoking, drinking, playing your fucking stuff.
Cigarettes and alcohol.
Gino, you're up next. Let's drop the beat. What's the matter to you?
I've got a
shot. Shush you! Ah! I got it! Shut up, you bitch! Okay.
Oh,
all right. Okay, the scores at the end of that round are shitty! We're gonna go to an ad break now, so have a poo. We'll see you in two. Let's have a dance. Coming up after break. What is Gino doing here?
In bag, going Gino, you gimpo.
Holly's team.
Is he taking part in Ready, Steady, Cock?
Welcome back to Celebrity Juice. Bern, are you a big fan of jungle?
Yeah.
You look like you grew up in the jungle. Russell, do you ever get mistaken for a lesbian?
I don't quite feminine here, don't I? I like Liza Minnelli and Vag, I'm quite confusing.
Because you think you like dressing as a lass though, don't you?
It's been known. Yes.
Charity. We've got a picture of you here dressed as Fern Cotton.
I'm glad that's a close-up, because the full shot, I've got a camel toe going on.
That's you dressed as Beyonce on Let's Dance for Comic Relief.
Yeah, you're very good at
that. I got into that a bit too much. Do you know, the weirdest thing happened? I've never done gymnastics or anything like that, but I was able to get down into all these really weird positions really quickly. I can do, like, a full crab position.
Crab
like...
it up, let's see, go on.
Yeah, let's have a look.
Let's get the boys' jimmies out on TV. Okay, ready? I'm going to try and do a full crab now. Ready?
Oh, my...
I thought you were...
Ooh. There's all to play for in this final round. It's the buzzer round! Yes! Our teams will buzz in if they know the answer. If you don't know the answer, be a chance of buzzing anyway. You might get it right. So, Holly, what is your buzzer this week?
Ivan Gomez, Gino de Campo!
His real voice there! Wednesday, what's your buzzer this week?
You're twisting me melons, man! Call the cops!
Okay, first question. Why is Sean Ryder furiously winking here?
You're twisting me melons, man! Call the cops!
Fern's team, is he ripped to the tits on amphetamines?
Can I ask this?
Yes.
I'm going to see the play-by girls, Miss Whiplash and the other one.
Let's have a look, let's have a look. That's correct! What is Gino doing here?
In bag, gummy, Gino, the
council! Is he
Holly's team?
Is he growing someone's tits?
Bad Gomez, Gino de Campo!
Holly's team.
Is he taking part in Ready, Steady, Cock?
Bad Gomez, Gino Di Campo!
Polythene!
I think we're definitely on this morning looking at the set behind, and I don't know, I'm...
You're cooking something.
Popping a bottle of...
Milk?
Champagne or
Let's
milk.
Have a look. That's correct!
Look at Ruth's face! Look at Ruth's face!
Look at
that
Phil
is her
as
sex
well.
Face, isn't it?
Oh, look at yeah. Philip's face! Look at Philip's face! That's amazing!
What's this woman pointing at?
Ibag Gomez Gino Di Campo!
Polythene!
Is this another person who's pointing at Fern? You know that people keep doing that.
Could you say Fern? Let's have a look.
Yeah!
She's pointing at, look at her face, she's pointing at it, yeah. She's going, it's her! That's the one I hate on the telly! That one there!
That Fern Britain, isn't it?
That's Fern Britain with the elastic yeah. band round her arsehole!
That's the facts, and that's the end of the buzz around. That's the end of this week's Celebrity Juice. I can tell you that the winners are... They're just totting it up now.
I don't think so, Sean.
No,
it's Holly's team!
Jane on Twitter says, after tonight, Thursdays just won't be the same, and Helena is gutted. So, yeah, that was the last in the series, but fear not. Keith's bound to be doing something good for Christmas. And you'll love this. There's the Celebrity Juice 2 Juicy for TV DVD. It's available from the 21st of November from all good stockists.